إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهديه الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا تجد له وليا مرشدا الحمد لله الذي جعل الأموال نعمة من نعمه والحمد لله الذي جعل الأرزاق نعمة من نعمه والحمد لله الذي جعل الإنفاق عبادة من عباداته والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد بن عبد الله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين وبعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, after thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and praising our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as you have heard from our brother on the issue of al-infaq fi sabilillah, today is a day where you are going to assess yourself. How much do you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Today is your day. You are going to assess yourself. How much you love your pockets and your accounts. It is a day when you should feel for others. And we all know that amwal ni'ma min ni'amillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. None among us has written any application to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to become a wealthy person. Never is there anyone who has applied to become a poor person. These are qadarun min aqdarillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala, the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He created among us the needy ones, and then he created also those who have the wealth ones. Why? So that you sympathize and give those who are in need. And the more you give, the more you appreciate the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you are to sit and count the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you human beings, لَا تُحْصُوهَا, you will never come unto end of it. Never. Never. And if we don't want to go deeper to those ni'mah, there are many of them, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yuhibbu idha an'ama ala 'abdihi an yara athar hadhihi an-ni'am. Aywa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yuhibbu dhalika. Wa lidhalika yaqulu wa amma bi ni'mati rabbika fahaddith. Al-hadith huna la ya'ni an tatafakhkhara bi dhalika an-ni'am aw bi tilka an-ni'ma. La hasha. Wa la ya'ni أن تقوم أمام الناس وتقول لهم أنا فعلت كذا وكذا وكذا وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث هو أن يرى الله سبحانه وتعالى هذه النعمة التي أنعمك الله سبحانه وتعالى تستعملها ويستفيد الآخرين وتفيد نفسك وتستفيد الأمة الإسلامية. When we are talking about the ni'ma of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's not an issue of you to be known that you have money, you have wealth, you have houses, you have properties. It's not enough. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul, وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةُ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. Al-hadith huna does not mean you stand and praise yourself in front of people. Neither do you need to show people how much you have in your account. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows each one of us here. We have been requested to contribute. Maybe you have hidden yourself because of one reason or another. But after prayers, the contribution will continue. And whoever will hide himself, I don't know what is in your pocket. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows, يَعْلَمُ السِّرَّ وَأَخْفَى. So keep on hiding. But you should remember, my dear brother, the more you give, the more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens the door of His mercy to you. The more you give, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes your life easy on this earth. And the more you become steam, the more you become a khair, the more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will also stop you to earn and to benefit from this wealth which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given. So don't think you're wise when you see that you have gone to your account and you have checked, you have these millions, alhamdulillah. There are some people get sick because they are not used in their accounts to have less than 5 million. A day he sees 1 million in his account, that day he will never wake up, subhanallah. And there are people who have nothing in their accounts other than the accounts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which will never go empty. So we want you today to do business with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ تِجَارَةٍ تُنْجِيكُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَتُجَاهِدُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بِأَمْوَالِكُمْ وَأَنفُسِكُمْ. Allah started with amwal because He knows how much we are in love with our amwal. A person can do anything, but when it comes to man, you become hesitant. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And because he knew the Arabs used to love business, they used to love money, he used that statement, أَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ تِجَارَةٍ تُنْجِيكُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. I'm going to use the same also. أَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ يَا أَهْلَ هَذَا الْمَسْجِدِ بِخَيْرٍ قَدْ آتَاكُمْ. Don't I inform my dear brothers and sisters today? How many mosques are there in Nairobi? Many. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen you today to pray purposely in this mosque so that you contribute for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And never think that you will lose anything. That money will not go to anybody's pocket. And even if it goes, it's none of your business. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will pay you as per your intention. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ وَإِنَّمَا لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مَا نَوَى. If your intention is to support our brothers and sisters, animals, youngsters, children who are dying in Northeastern, who are dying in Kilifi, who are dying in Tana River. Yesterday, I had a meeting with some brothers from Tana River. Subhanallah, you may think these are Al-Fleda Wela stories, but it's reality. A Muslim died in Tana River just last week. And this deceased body could not be washed because there was no water. Imagine. It's really pathetic. It is pathetic. So unless we Muslims, we feel those incidents which are happening there, our brothers will keep on dying and dying and dying. There will be no angels who will come to give them anything because Allah knows that you are here as a Khalifa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, many people have that culture of knowing, what will I benefit if I give? Wallahi, there are a lot of benefits. A lot of benefits. تُجَاهِدُونَ بِأَمْوَالِكُمْ وَأَنفُسِكُمْ. It's part of jihad. بَيُّ أَمْوَالِكُمْ. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, among the trials which has kept for us in the day of judgment, is the jar. And among the things the jar will come with is wealth, money. Because he knows human beings are crazy when it comes. يُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمَّا. يُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمَّا. The jar will be moving with wealth following him. The gold, the diamond. Now if you want to be with the jar, keep your money in your account. You leave your money here, you will go there empty-handed, people have died, and you are responsible for any death because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not given that money for you to keep it. Now let us see a little bit, what do we benefit when we give? يقول سبحانه وتعالى. Among the things when you give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially in this environment we're living, especially in this case where we have already explained past, where we have already been, it has already been explained past, من ثمرات الإنفاق في سبيل الله دخول الجنة. ولهذا سمعتم الأخ قال يدعو لإخواننا الذين أنفقوا في سبيل الله أن يدخلهم الله سبحانه وتعالى الجنة. وأنا أزيد على ذلك اللهم أدخل كل من أنفق أموالي في الجنة يا رب العالمين. وزد في أمواله يا رب العالمين. والذي ليس له نية, and whoever has no intention to give, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make him humble and submit himself before the finishing of this khutbah. He gives for the sake of Allah, she gives for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should not forget that we have sisters upstairs there. There are sisters who also earn properties. There are sisters who are also rich more than men, some of them, of course. So my dear sister, wherever you are there, we are waiting for your contribution after prayer. And I believe, and always I have seen with my experience, whenever we go to contributions, always women lead others follow. I believe men will never allow this time, inshallah, believe in Allah. So a man, the thamaratul infaq fi sabilillah, the benefits. When you give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what do you gain? Dukhul al-jannah. ماذا يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى؟ يقول تبارك الله وتعالى وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة أرضها السماوات والأرض. سارعوا. He never said walk. He never said move. وسارعوا. Move fast. Towards what? Towards what Allah سبحانه وتعالى says. جنة. جنة. A paradise. A جنة which أعدت للمتقين. Jannah which is prepared for the people who are God conscious, people who are pious people, people who are submitted. A Jannah, the wedding of that Jannah, samawat wal ard, is a place where you can never say, oh, the place is congested, I don't have a place to enter. Wallahi, you will never find that. In fact, my last khutbah in Kadiyar, last Friday khutbah in Kadiyar, I was telling the people how to construct a house in Jannah. A house which you don't need a survey, you don't need a title deed. You will never find that your land has been grabbed and say, Ya Allah, my land, none of that will never happen. Jannah, arduha as-samawat wal ard. Look at the heaven and the earth. It's bigger as what you can see here. No condition. You don't need a plan. Simple things you do them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepare for you a house in Jannah. You don't need to go to a texture to be written for you, prepared, drawn for you a plan. Never do you need to pay to the county council. Never do you need to bring soldiers and policemen to be, you know, taking care of your property. That is a property which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept for you. And remember, my dear brothers, we should learn from these verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the instance of those people who were before us. If a woman like Imrat Fir'aun, she had billions, in fact, I don't know, we can say even trillions. She had power, she had slaves, she had palaces, she had everything. But when she looked at it, she knew that one day I will leave these properties here on earth. One day, Fir'aun will never assist me. Your lawyer will never assist you. Your son will never assist you. Your brother will never assist you. Whoever is there will never assist you. That's why Imrat Fir'aun was very wise, very intelligent. And I want our sister to be like Imrat Fir'aun. نظر في الدنيا فإذا ليس بشيء فنظر في الأموال التي كان جمعت أمامها فنظرت فراء ليس بشيء فماذا قال؟ فقال يا رب ابن لي عندك بيتا في الجنة. ابن لي بيتا في الجنة. اللهم نسألك يا ربنا في هذه المناسبة أن تبني لنا بيوتا في الجنة وابني بيتا لكل من يفق اليوم في الجنة بإذن الله. رب ابني لي عندك بيتا في الجنة. بيتا في الجنة يا إخوة. He never asked for a palace in الجنة. A bait. Small rooms في الجنة. ربي ابني لي بيتا. ربي ابني لي بيتا يا رب. Let you give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And wallahi, you will never be disappointed. This is a true business between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will never get disappointed at all. Salawat wal arf. The bigger as you can imagine. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul u'iddat lil muttaqin. Is prepared for the God conscious people. Now the God conscious people, you will never see them on their faces. Neither will you see them on their type of dress they're putting on. But the best people are those who always committed to deliver for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always they are ready to give their money, to give their property, to give everything to rescue our brothers. Subhanallah al-kinnas. الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء الإنفاق يجوز في السر وفي الجهر. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has permitted us. It is allowed. And never think those people who have stood here today to give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that it will go sooner. Never. It is allowed to give it openly, and it is also allowed to give it in privacy. If you have not contributed now, the time is not too late. At the end of our prayers, inshallah, I believe we are believers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have the feelings of our brothers and sisters, and the animals who are dying, you are going to give it. Even if it's 50 shillings, it will do something. 50 shillings, it will do something. Whatever you have, give it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fi sarra'i wa dharra'i. Number two, what is the benefit? Having entered paradise. Another benefit for whoever gives zakat al-sadaqah or al-infaq fi sabilillah. Mada, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect him from nar. Will protect him from nar. You will never enter paradise if you give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yaqulu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi hadithin akharajahu al-Bukhariyu. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم اتقوا النار ولو شق التمر او تمره اتقوا النار fear the hellfire. Wallahi, the fire, we can never handle ourselves in that place. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us away from it. And the only way for us to be kept away from it is us to make infaq, to give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اتقوا النار fear the hellfire. Even if it's you to contribute something small like a piece of debt. Now imagine 50 shillings, it won't be nothing. Now imagine a person was given 100,000, a person was given 200,000. Don't you also want to compete with those people? تصادقوا إلى الخيرات فليتنافس المتنافسون. فليتنافس المتنافسون في ماذا؟ في أعمال الخير. Let there be people who will compete one another, not for constructions. That I have a house in so-so place. Pharaoh had, and the wife of Pharaoh had also, but she never bothered. She was looking only for a house, not for a palace. Now, if you have a house, say Alhamdulillah, we don't mean that you should not look at your dunya, because at dunya mazarat al-akhirah. You can never succeed in Akhirah if you don't do anything on dunya. So you need to have man, you need to have wealth, you need to have property so that you give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't keep them, my dear. They will go. Before you came, there were people who had those money also, and they left them here. They had those properties also, they left them here. They went there alone. You shall go alone, my dear brother and sister. So, among the benefits, because as I know, many of the people here are businessmen, top shots. They always want to remain where they are. But remember, you will leave them one day. So, give even if it is small. We don't want to become like the church people whereby you say, if you don't give, tomorrow don't come, or next Friday don't come to the mosque. We're not going to tell you that. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. Allah knows what you have. So whether you come next Friday or you not come, it's between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah knows each one what you have in your pocket. If you don't give it, you know better than us. My dear brother and sister in Islam, finally Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل في كل سنبلة 100 حبة والله يضاعف لمن يشاء والله واسع عليم. سورة البقرة آية 361. مثل الذين ينفقون في سبيل الله. Allah likes to give parables. He likes to give the likes or the examples or the things which with similarities. So he says, مثل الذين ينفقون في سبيل الله. The parable of those who give, the likeness of those who give في سبيل الله. Now, how many times have you contributed في سبيل الشيطان? Ask yourself. How many times? We don't want to raise up your hand. Just ask yourself. يقول الله مثل الذين ينفقون في سبيل الله. The likeness of those who give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the sake of the paradise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the sake of him being protected from adab al-qadr. مثلهم كمثل حبة is like a grain of corn or a seed, small seed. Okay? كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل. That small seed grows how many years? 7 years. في كل سنبلة on each ear 100 حبة. There is 100 pieces of those small seeds. On each of those 7 years, there are how many? 100 pieces. That is 100 times 7 is almost 700. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never finished there. He said, يضاعف الله لمن يشاء. ميتحب والله يضاعف لمن يشاء. والله واسع عليم. Allah will add and increase for the ones he wants. For the ones who will give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will know them. He will increase on them. So among the benefits is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increases your wealth. The more you give, the more you get increased. And that is for sure because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he doesn't speak anything other than what is true. It is true. And I want you to make it as a test today. I remember an incident. A brother of mine, of my friend, he gave a friend of him who was badly in need 50,000 shillings. And he said, I'm giving this one not a day, I'm giving to you fi sabilillah. Because he had a problem. And this is how Muslim should be. After a while, immediately he left there, he had a day, a loan from a brother of him who has spent almost 5 years. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made that guy to pay that loan very easily. Then he called, salamu alaykum. Wallahi, the 50,000 I've given you, I have got my 200,000 which I've been following for the last 5 years. So for those who have their debts and their loans from their colleagues and friends, please give it today. And don't give it as a trial because sheikh has said, let me try and see. You may not be giving, of course, because you're trying. You're not sure of what we're saying. We are saying practically has happened. It may happen to you, it may not, but I assure you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never disappoint you. Now let me finish with the akhlaq of giving. Okay? There are some conditions. When you give, you don't give anyhow. Number one is al-ikhlasu lillahi. To be sincere when you're giving. Be sincere that I give. Don't be hesitating. Maybe I'll get it somewhere. Maybe I'll give it with ikhlas. That is number one. When you give it with that ikhlas, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will pay you back. And I have already recited that hadith, which is mentioned here also. Innama al-a'malu bin niyati wa innama li kulli imri ma nawa. Niyatuka an-niyya hiya allati sawfa tus'alu yawm al-qiyamah. لا تسأل كم عدد الذي دفعته ولا تسأل كم عدد الأموال التي أعطيته إنما ما هي النية التي أعطيت بها هذه الأموال. What was your intention? That will be the question. Whether you give it small or a big quantity of amwal, it doesn't matter before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير هو الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوك أيكم أحسن عملا. Allah is after quality and not after quantity. You may give a lot of money, but if you don't have ikhlas, you don't have sincerity, that money will just go and will never get away. عدم المن والأذى. عدم المن والأذى. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تبطلوا صدقاتكم بالمن والأذى. There are some people when we give them money, then they go and talk about behind it. Don't do that. Give it and forget it. Don't say, these people have spoiled my budget. You lose, my dear. Which budget are you planning? A few days, one of my students came to me and said, Sheikh, there are plots which are being sold somewhere. Do you want? I said, yes, I want to buy. But there is no title. They said, I don't need title deed. I'm not here to stay. We are passing. So long as I have a paper that I'm the owner of that land, whether with or without it. How many people have title deed today on this earth, in this country, and yet their lands have been grabbed? So long as you have a paper that you are that house, you don't need so many stories. So never think that we'll remain here forever. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this, manna or other. Never be talking behind it that I gave it because I wanted to be known. I gave it because our people have spent my budget. Never do that, because that it will make you not to get the reward which has been described in the Quran. Number three and the last one. Which type of amwal, which type of wealth do you give? Or which type of man is qualified to be given a sadaqah? Al-malu tayyib, the good money. For the pesa, I don't know, the gambling way, people, everyone today is in those business of riba today. People, Muslims participating in beating or, betting. Eh? The pesa what? All those type of riba are haram. They are haram. I don't know their name. Toboa, I don't know, Totoa. They are all haram. They are haram because that is riba. So if your money has come through that source, that money should never be given as what? As for sadaqa. Or if it is an interest of your money which you have kept in a bank, there is another way ulama have accepted and allowed you to spend that money but never expect to get any reward. Spend that money for something which will be general. The Muslims and non-Muslims will benefit from that. But never expect any reward, then ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you. Never leave that money in the bank because it will be misused. And this has been a mistake of many Muslims. Those who have money in the banks, then they are given their interest. They say, no, give me my money, leave that one. Some of them they are taking to construct bars and clubs. You will be punished for that. Take that money, which you have identified that it is haram, it is riba. Go and construct a well where a Muslim and a non-Muslim will benefit. Go and construct a borehole where a non-Muslim and a Muslim will benefit, and never expect any reward. Then ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you for that. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم فتقبل مني ومنكم تلاوته وهو الغفور الرحيم فاستغفر الله. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. ثم أصلي وأسلم على نبينا محمد الذي قال الله تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد ورضي أصحاب رسول الله خصوصا منهم سيدنا أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه وسيدنا عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه وسيدنا عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه وسيدنا علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه وجميع أصحاب رسول الله رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين وانصر إخواننا في الصومال وانصر إخواننا في العراق وانصر إخواننا في سوريا وانصر إخواننا في كل مكان يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر إخواننا الذين يموتون بالمجاعة والجفاف في هذا البلد يا رب العالمين اللهم انصرهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم افتح لنا أبواب أرزاقك يا رب العالمين أرزاقا حلالا طيبا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم إن كانت أرزاقنا في السماء فأمطرها لنا وإن كانت أرزاقنا في الأرض فأنبتها لنا وإن كانت أرزاقنا قليلا فكثرها لنا وإن كانت أرزاقنا بعيدا فقربها لنا يا رب العالمين إن الله يأمركم بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله تعالى أكبر أقول ما تسمعون وأقيموا الصلاة